Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are all welcome back to Black Rose TV. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for being here. And if this is your first time on my channel, I'm pleased to have you. Just do me a little favor by clicking on that subscribe button right below. And guess what? If you want to be the first person to get notified whenever I upload a new video, you know what to do. Just click on that notification bell beside the subscription button so that you can get the notification, the first actual person to get notified whenever I upload a new video. So let's go right into our video. But before that, you guys, we have hit 350 subscribers, like over 350 subscribers. I am really excited, and thank you guys. I cannot thank you enough, because in my previous video I told you guys that I want to hit 350 subscribers, and I must say I am surprised, because whenever I upload a new video I get like 5 new subscribers, or like at maximum 6-7 subscribers. But this time I have gotten over 10 subscribers, and for just single video, and I must say I am really grateful for this. By the end of this video, I'm going to talk you through my YouTube journey, how it has been for me. But before then, let's go into the real business. We often hear, like, we often greet ourselves in Ramadan with Ramadan Kareem or Ramadan Mubarak. So earlier this morning, and ever since the moon has been sighted, I've been seeing people posting Ramadan Kareem, Ramadan Mubarak, and you know, people just greet themselves. People congratulate one another about Ramadan in different using different terms. So I'm here to tell you the difference between Ramadan Mubarak and Ramadan Kareem. So earlier this morning I posted on my Facebook status, what do you use? Which one do you use, Ramadan Kareem or Ramadan Mubarak? And the answer was not quite encouraging on Facebook, but I also posted it on my WhatsApp status, which one do you use, Ramadan Kareem or Ramadan Mubarak? And the answers were like 50-50. Some they use both, some they use only Ramadan Mubarak, and some they only use Ramadan Kareem. So people that I told it was the appropriate thing to use is Ramadan Mubarak were asking me questions. So I told them to wait for the answers in this video, and this is the video. If you have replied to me with Ramadan Kareem, this video is for you specially. So the word Kareem is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it means generous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most generous. So when you say Ramadan Kareem, you're saying that the month is generous, and the month happens to be time, an element of time. It is a month, and which is an element of time. So time, as we know, it is not generous. Rather, it is actually taken every minute. With the passage of minutes, time is taken. So when you say Ramadan Kareem, you are giving the month actually an attribute of Allah Azza wa Jal. But when you say Ramadan Mubarak, the word Mubarak means blessed, and we know the month is filled with a lot of blessings, with abundant, with endless blessings. So the right thing for one to use is Ramadan Mubarak. What actually made me to make this video again is a post that I saw on a friend's WhatsApp status, because hello, we're in Ramadan, so now our status have changed to, you know, enlightening one another, reminding us about, you know, different things about the month, or encouraging us to do more. So this friend posted these pictures that are coming up right on the screen, and you can see the difference between Ramadan Kareem and Ramadan Mubarak. I hope it clarifies more. So another thing that I want to talk about in this video is complaining. Yep, I know. We are in the season of complaining. Ramadan has now turned to not just the blessed month, but a season, but a month of complaining, because of, you know, the weather and the condition and a lot of things. Instead of complaining, why don't you just sit and ask Allah, pray to Allah to grant you the reward, to reward you for this, for whatever you're complaining about. Because Ramadan is a month that teaches us perseverance and patience and endurance. It teaches us patience by urging us to remain steadfast in our duty to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While reaping the benefits and the blessings of this month, we shouldn't complain to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the hardship or how intense this fasting is, because it demands a lot from us on many levels, be it patience, discipline, endurance, you name it. And for me, I believe the sole reason of Ramadan is for it to teach us fasting, as I've stated, and I will keep repeating this just to show you how important it is. I know it is hard, and especially being in Khartoum, one of the hottest cities in the world. I mean, I was indoors and the power was off, but it was really hot. So it got me thinking, like, how about those that are actually going out in this scorching heat to actually fend for themselves? How do they feel? So I was like, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. And one thing that we all Muslims that we should say whenever we find ourselves in a hard situation is to thank Allah in any situation. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. And we should ask Allah to bless us or to reward us for this struggle that we are going through. I know it is hard, but please do not complain about Ramadan. You are only taking away from your reward, because when you are complaining to Allah that things are hard for you. And la yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wus'aha. Allah does not burden a soul with what it cannot carry. Meaning, like, Allah will not put you in a position that He knows you cannot go through. He will help us through this holy month of Ramadan, the blessed month. It is hard, I know, but please do not complain. Ramadan has turned into a season of complaining from brothers, from sisters. It is hard. I, for one, do not go out during the days of Ramadan, except if I'm going to film. And that is mandatory for me, because I cannot obviously film in the hostel due to a lot of people living there. You might be filming and somebody might just decide to interrupt you. So that is not like a good place for me to film. So I have to go, you know, somewhere far from the hostels where I can find peace and quiet. And this is the highest level of peace and quiet I can find around here. You guys, the struggle is real. I want to use this moment to pray for the Nigerian students that are going to school in this condition. It is not easy. We all know that it is not easy and it is hard, but you guys are still going to school, going to classes. I cannot begin to imagine. Like, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you guys on this struggle that you are on, this path that you are working on. And I just want to say that I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it easier for you and strengthen you through this journey. So if you happen to be a student and is going to school in this condition, in this weather, I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may He ease your affairs and may He strengthen you and may He reward your struggles. So you guys, the real deal is here. Like, in my previous video, I posted that I want to hit 350 subscribers. And guess what, you guys? Just check my subscribers right now. I am like 354, 56, something like that. I don't even know the correct, like, the actual number, but I know it's almost 356 subscribers. You know what that means? I just want to say thank you so much for being with me. Thank you so much for being with me, like, through this journey, and for us to come really this far, it means something for me. I know it's not like, you know, some kind of big victory, because of the threshold we need to hit 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 watch hours. That is a huge and a lot amount of watch hours for one to actually attain on YouTube. But people are making it, and I do believe that I am going to hit that by the end of this year. So why I want to include this, my YouTube journey, in this video is because last Ramadan that happened, 2020, in the pandemic, was when I first hit my 100 subscribers. And you know what, I started YouTube in 2018, late 2018, yeah, something like that, 2018, around August, yeah, August 2018, something like that, August, September, I'm not too sure about the dates that I started, that I first uploaded a YouTube video. And within the span of 2 years, I barely hit 100 subscribers. And now I have over 350. Within a span of a year, I have 150 more subscribers. No, I mean 250 more subscribers added to it. Do you know what that means? We are making progress. And this progress, even though it's baby steps, it is something that I want to celebrate. It is something that I really appreciate, that is really dear to my heart. Within a span of, it took me 2 years to hit 100 subscribers. And now within a year, I have doubled it, or rather tripled it. So by the end of Ramadan, I have another target. I have a huge target. And inshallah, by the end of every video, I'm going to remind you guys that we have a target to hit by the end of Ramadan. We want to hit 500 subscribers. If we can get 354 subscribers. If we can go this far, it shouldn't be hard for us to hit 500 subscribers by the end of Ramadan. And inshallah, by the end of this year, I am going to hit that threshold. I am going to have those 1,000 subscribers. It is not easy. We all know if you're a content creator, it's not easy for you to sit down, get the content, gather the ideas, put them in one place, you know, set up a video, film it yourself and edit and actually manage everything yourself. It is not easy, you guys. This is actually a lot of work. Because like for someone like me who is really, for someone like me, for me to actually sit down and put down my ideas in one place, it is actually quite hard for me because my ideas will be all over the place. I'll have a tons of ideas up here, but for me to be able to sit down and put them in order, that is a very big thing for me. It's really difficult for me, but I still try to do so. So thank you guys so much for actually being with me, for believing me and for believing in me and for supporting me. I really appreciate and I hope we can be able to hit those 500 subscribers. Why I wanted 350 subscribers in my previous video was just for me to see if we can be able to make this. And trust me, you guys, you have shown it to me. Now you guys have given me hope that I can reach 500 subscribers by the end of Ramadan. So I am counting on you guys. We need to hit 500 subscribers. Let's keep sharing this video. It is not just for us to hit, but for us, because my videos, I don't feel like uploading a video is for, it's not the matter of, it is not the number of subscribers that count, but the number of impactful work is doing. I don't just want to hit those subscribers because I want to have subscribers, but I want to hit those subscribers for them to actually come on this journey with me, for us to be able to educate ourselves and remind ourselves on things that we have forgotten. This is the essence of my YouTube videos. So I just want to say, don't forget to, you know, give me that thumbs up, subscribe, like, and most importantly, keep sharing this video. Do not hesitate to share this video if you find it beneficial with your friends, family, co-workers, you know, with anybody else that comes your way. Just share this video with them on different platforms, Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, you name it. So I just want to say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and most importantly, let's not forget, Ramadan Mubarak.